हेलो किड्स, वेलकम बैक। सो लास्ट टाइम वी स्टडीड अबाउट लेंथ एंड मास। यस, टुडे वी विल स्टडी सम न्यू टॉपिक्स। यस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन लेट्स रिवाइज व्हाट एवर वी स्टडीड अबाउट लेंथ एंड मास। यू नो व्हाट इज लेंथ? यस, व्हाट इज लेंथ? Length is the distance between two points. Yes, what is length? Length is the distance between two points. Okay, and what is the basic unit of length? What is the basic unit of length? Yes, we know that basic unit of length is meter. Yes, basic unit of length is meter. And you know that 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Kilometer is bigger unit, meter is smaller unit. Yes, in short, kilometer is written by km, meter is written by m, centimeter is written by cm. Okay, and we also studied about mass. Yes, we also studied about the mass. Mass means the amount of matter in an object is known as mass. And what is the unit of mass? Kilogram. Yes, the basic unit of mass is kilogram. Am I right? And as you can see on the screen, yes, as you can see on your screen, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram. 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligram. Yes, and last time I gave you some question. I hope that you might have solved. Now today we will study about capacity and time. Yes, we will study about capacity and time and temperature also. Okay, but before we begin, let me tell you one more definition of mass. Okay, one more definition of mass. So you, I hope that you will memorize the definition. Now let's see the definition. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, so what is mass? The amount of matter in an object. Yes, and another definition you can see, mass is a measure of how heavy or something is. Yes, mass is measure of how heavy or light an object is. Yes, how heavy? If I am heavy, I have mass, I have more mass. If I am light, I have less mass. My weight is 50 kilogram, means I am heavy, I have more mass. But if my mass is 30 kilogram, means I have less mass. So mass actually measures the weight. Mass actually measures the weight. But you know what is the interesting fact, kids? What is the interesting fact? When you will go in higher classes, then you will really get confused that actually mass and weight both are different thing. Yes, mass and weight both are different thing. Because if I say my weight is 50 kilogram and if I say my mass is 50 kilogram, how comes it possible? No, it's not possible. How can both are same? Yes. How can mass is 50 kilogram and how can weight is 50 kilogram? Both cannot be same. There is a little bit, there are some differences between, both are different. Mass and weight, both are different terms. Okay. When you go to shopkeeper and suppose you say to shopkeeper, give me 1 kilogram sugar. What is 1 kilogram? 1 kilogram is weight of sugar or mass of sugar? Think and tell me. 1 kilogram is a weight of sugar or mass of sugar? It is mass of sugar, not weight of sugar. Weight is different thing. Yes, you will study in higher class what is weight, what is the difference. Actually, we get the weight when we multiply with the 9.81. Okay. So there are some differences between mass and weight. Okay. Actually, both are different. But we are on the earth. That's why we calculate mass and weight. We measure the mass and weight. Both are same for us on the earth. Otherwise, actually, it is both are different. Yes. If I say my weight is 50 kilogram, if I say my weight is 50 kilogram, it is wrong. My weight is not 50 kilogram. It is actually mass. My mass is 50 kilogram. My mass is 50 kilogram because mass is measured in kilogram. Mass is measured in kilogram. What is weight? Weight is actually a force. Weight is actually a force. Yes. In next chapter, in chapter 9, I will explain what is force. Okay, don't worry. So this is also the definition. What is mass? Mass is a measure of how heavy or light an object is, or you can say the amount of matter in an object is known as mass. I hope you understood. Okay, now I drink water. I am thirsty. Okay, so I should drink water. There was a crow. He was very thirsty. He went here and there. And before drinking the water, you know, I washed my hand with sanitizer. Isn't it? Okay. So I hope you understood the difference between mass and weight. Okay. Now we are going to study about capacity. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, we are gonna start capacity. So I have the bottle right now in my hand. Okay. So can you tell me what is the capacity of this bottle? What is the capacity of this bottle? The capacity of this bottle is 1 liter. Yes, I think 1 liter is the capacity of this bottle. So what is liter? Liter is the basic unit. Yes, you know, when you go to shopkeeper gives you oil in liter. Yes, if you buy the packet, of oil, check the capacity, check out, read the instruction which are given on the packet. You will find that the weight of this one, the capacity is actually 1 liter. So what is liter? Liter is the capacity. Now, definition of capacity. Capacity means how much a container can hold. Capacity means how much a container can hold. I have this bottle. I filled the water inside it. Yes, I filled the water. How much water can this bottle can hold? How much water can this bottle hold? Yes, this bottle can hold 1 liter. So what is the capacity of this bottle? 1 liter. Yes. So as you can see in the picture, look the picture of bucket. Yes, can you see the picture of bucket? So look the picture of bucket and tell me that what is the capacity of this bucket. Yes, what is the capacity of this bucket? 13.5 liter. This is the capacity of this bucket. So it means how much water can this bucket hold? 13.5 liter. How much water can my bottle hold? 1 liter, yes, because this is the capacity of this bottle. This cannot hold more than 1 liter because the water will overflow, the water will come out. Yes, am I right? So capacity means how much a container can hold. I hope you might have written the definition of capacity, and mass you already know that mass is measurement of an object, how heavy or light an object is. Okay, now the question is what is the capacity measured in? What is capacity measured in? Let's find out the answer. Let's move on the next point. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, what is capacity measured in? What is capacity measured in? Yes, what is capacity measured in? Capacity is measured in usually milliliter or liter. Yes, capacity is measured in milliliter or liter. Am I right? So ml, you can see on the screen, ml means milliliter, and l stand for liter. Yes, we represent liter by a letter l, and ml for milliliter. Okay, l is the short form of liter is l, and the short form of milliliter is ml. Okay, remember kids, if I ask you what is the basic unit of capacity, what is the basic unit of capacity? Yes, liter is the basic unit of capacity. Yes, remember. Okay, and what is milliliter, milliliter, ml is the short form of milliliter. Kiloliter kl is the short form of kiloliter. ml is the short form of milliliter, and kl is the short form of kiloliter. Okay, I hope you got it. And remember, the basic unit of capacity is liter. Milliliter is the smaller unit, kiloliter is the bigger unit. Yes, milliliter is smaller unit, kiloliter is bigger unit. And as you can see on the screen, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Yes, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter, and 1000 liter is equal to 1 kiloliter. Yes, you know the big tank of our washroom tank that we put at the top the washroom, they are actually in kiloliter. Yes, generally they are actually they contains 10,000 liter. Yes, means 10 kiloliter, because 1000 liter equal to 1 kiloliter, then 10,000 liter is equal to 10 kiloliter liter. Yes, it's very easy. So please write down what is capacity measured in. Capacity is measured in milliliter and liter, and 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter, 1000 liter is equal to 1 kiloliter. Okay, please write down. Till then I drink water because I am thirsty, just like once there was a crow, he was very thirsty. Let's begin. Okay kids, so I hope that you might have written. Okay, and now let's move on the next slide. Okay kids, now we will study the new topic, measurement of time. Yes, now we will study about time, measurement of time. Okay, so measurement of time, first of all we will see the definition of time. Yes, you know we use watch. I don't have watch. Yes, I don't have watch. It is a red color thread. So we use watch, different type of watch, analog watch, digital watch, and there are different type of watch. You know, in ancient time, how did people find the time? Yes, how did they get to know about the time? Yes, can you tell me the answer? Using sundial. Using sundial, sand watch. Yes, they also had sand watch. So they used them to find out about the time. Yes, they used them to find out about the time. So what is time? The period between two events is called time. The period between two events is called time. Yes. The period. Right now the time is 4:57. And maybe in your watch, maybe the time be different because you are watching the video at that time. Yes, it's possible. So what is the time? The period between two events is called two events. Yes, the period between two events is called time. Yes. So if I ask you, what is the basic unit of time? Second. Basic unit of time. What is the basic unit of time? Second. Yes. Basic unit of time is second, and second is denoted by small s. Yes, second is denoted by small s, as you can see on the your screen. Yes, as you can see on your screen, second is denoted by small s. Okay, so kids, the period between two event is called time. The period between two event is called time. The period between two event is called time. And you know, in present time we use smartwatch to find out the time. Yes, in ancient time they used they just tried to guess the time. You look at the sun and try to find out the time, or they used a sand watch, and there is also water watch, if you know, and sundial in Jaipur there is a big watch which is actually a sundial. Yes, if you ever get the chance to go to Jaipur, you should watch it. Yes, it is actually in a Jantar Mantar. Yes, Jantar Mantar is a very good visiting place. You should go once and check out the ancient time watch. Yes, it is very big watch, even you cannot imagine. Okay, and there are some different units to measure the time. Yes, let's check out all the unit. Let's move on the next point. Okay kids, so measuring time. How to measure time? Yes, measuring time. How to measure time? So we measure time in second. Yes, usually we measure time in second, and I already told you that second is the unit, basic unit of time. We also measure time in minute. Yes, we also measure time in hours. We also measure time in days. We also measure time in weeks, months, years, season, fortnights. Yes, so minute, hours, days, weeks, we use them to measure time. And remember kids, minutes and second are smaller unit. Remember, always remember kids, minutes and seconds are smaller unit. Why? Hours is a bigger unit. Okay, and as you know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Yes, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, and 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And if I talk about days, there are 7 days in a week, and in one day there are 24 hours. 24 hours in a day and 7 days in a week. And if I talk about month and year, there are 12 months in a year: January, Feb, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. And there are 52 weeks in a year. Okay. Season, if we talk about the season, there are usually 4 seasons in a year: summer, autumn, winter, spring. Okay. And fortnight, what is the meaning of fortnight? Yes, this word is new for you. I think maybe this word is new for you. Fortnight, one fortnight is equal to 14 days. It means 2 weeks, because one week is equal to 7 days, 2 weeks is equal to 14 days. So 2 weeks is equal to fortnight. Okay. Now, if I ask you, how many fortnight are there in 42 days? How many fortnight are there in 42 days? Yes, three fortnight. And you know that, okay, give me the answer of one more question. How many minutes are there in 3 hours? How many minutes are there in 3 hours? Tell me, because you know that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Think and tell me, how many minutes are there in 3 hours? Your time start now. Yes, kids, there are 180 minutes. Yes. Okay. I hope you understood. Now, let's study the next topic. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, kids, next topic, temperature. Yes, what is temperature? The new topic. Today's new topic is, what is temperature? So, it is very easy topic, kids, so you no need to worry about it. Okay, temperature. It is very easy and interesting topic. Okay, so don't worry about it. So, what is temperature? What is temperature? Can you tell me what is temperature? Temperature is the measure of how hot or cold an object is. Yes. Right now, it is winter season. Right now, it is winter season. So, it is very cold. Winter season is very cold. It means temperature is very low. And in summer season, it is very hot. It means temperature is very high. So, temperature is actually the measurement of how hot or cold object is. How hot or cold an object is. Means, we can say the measurement of hotness or coldness is known as its temperature. The measurement of hotness or coldness of an object. The measurement of hotness or coldness of an object is known as its temperature. So, you know, it's as I told you that to measure the time, we use watch. Yes, digital watch, analog watch, smart watch. In the same way, to measure the temperature, we use thermometer. Yes, to measure the temperature, we use thermometer. Thermometer is used to measure temperature. Thermometer is used to measure temperature. Yes, as you can see the picture of thermometer. Yes, it is laboratory thermometer. Yes, you can see I have shown different color in the thermometer. You can see the picture is, I think, very small, so maybe possible. So you can see that red part is showing the hot, means when the temperature increase, then it is very hot, and the green part is showing coldness. Okay. So when the temperature decrease, when the temperature goes down, the level of temperature goes down, then it becomes cold. When the temperature increase, it becomes hot. So 0 degree is a freezing point, you can say. Okay. And 100 degrees Celsius is a boiling point, where the water start boiling. Okay. So as you can see, what is temperature? Temperature is the measure of how hot or cold an object is, and thermometer is used to measure the temperature. Okay, I hope you understood. Now the question is, what is the basic unit of temperature? What is the unit of temperature? What is the unit of temperature? Yes, the unit of temperature is F and C. Yes, these are two units. There are two units of temperature. Actually, there are three units. Actually, there are three units. F, C and K. K means Kelvin. K means Kelvin. What is the meaning of F? What is the meaning of C? Let's find out. Let's move on to the next point. So, what does F and C? Yes, F and C. F means Fahrenheit. F means Fahrenheit. C means Celsius. Degree Fahrenheit and degree Celsius. F means degree Fahrenheit. C means degree Celsius. So, temperature is measured in degree Fahrenheit and degree Celsius and as well as Kelvin. Yes. Because in your book, about Kelvin is not given, so I am not showing here. You can search Google, you can read on the Google, you can read on the YouTube about the Kelvin, Fahrenheit, Celsius. Okay. So I have written the temperature of human being, I have written the temperature of water, I have written the temperature when water freeze means, when water freeze means, when water freeze means when water change into ice. So when water freeze, the temperature in Celsius will be 0 degree Celsius, but the temperature in Fahrenheit, it will be 32 degree Fahrenheit. Yes, when water boils, when you boil the water, water is started converting into water vapor, that time its temperature is 100 degree Celsius. And in Fahrenheit, the temperature will be 212 Fahrenheit. Yes. And if I talk about our human body temperature, normal temperature, when you are not ill, that time the normal body temperature in Celsius is 37 degree Celsius, and the temperature in Fahrenheit is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, please write down. I am giving you 10 seconds. So kids, I hope you understood what is F and C. Temperature is measured in degree Fahrenheit means F, and degree Celsius means C. And the temperature of normal human body is 37 degree Celsius in Celsius and 98.6 degree in Fahrenheit. You know, if you go to any mall, the guard or anybody, they use a thermal screening. Yes, they use a thermal screening. They have a machine which measure the temperature. Digital thermometer is actually, it is a digital thermometer which find out the temperature. It find the temperature in Celsius or Fahrenheit. Okay, so if your temperature is 37 degree or 36 degree or 38 degree, then you are okay. Or if your temperature is 98, 97 or 99, you are okay. Okay, but if it is more, it's dangerous. Okay, I hope you understood. Now it's time to ask question from you. Let's move on the last point. Okay, it's a time to ask question from you. So question number one, how is temperature measured? Yes, how is temperature measured? So first of all, let me tell you the definition of temperature. Temperature is the measurement of how hot or cold an object is. Yes, temperature is the measurement of how hot or cold an object is. And temperature is measured using a thermometer. Temperature is measured using a thermometer. Temperature is measured in Fahrenheit, Celsius or Kelvin. Yes, temperature is measured in Fahrenheit, Celsius as well as Kelvin. I hope you understood. Yes, what is temperature? The hotness or coldness of an object is called its temperature. Okay, temperature is measured using a thermometer. Thermometer, there are different type of thermometer. Yes kids, There are different type of thermometer. In 7th class you will study about all thermometer, like digital thermometer, laboratory thermometer, okay? There are different type of thermometer, okay? Next question, question number 2. What is capacity? Write its unit. Yes, what is capacity? Write its unit. What is capacity? Yes, can you tell me the definition of capacity? It's very easy. Capacity means capacity is defined as how much a container can hold any object, any matter, and maybe in liquid form. Okay, capacity means how much a container can hold. Capacity, how much a container can hold. And if I ask you what is capacity measured in, capacity is measured in liter, kiloliter, milliliter. Yes, you know about it. And what is the basic unit of capacity? What is the unit of capacity? The unit of capacity is liter. The unit of capacity is liter. Okay, the unit of capacity is liter. And smaller units, milliliter is smaller unit, kiloliter is bigger unit. Milliliter is smaller unit, kiloliter is bigger unit. And you know that, kids, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter and 1000 liter is equal to 1 kiloliter. Okay. Question number 3. What is the temperature of a normal body? Yes, what is the temperature of normal body? I already explained you, 37 degree in Celsius. If I am talking in Celsius, then I can say 37 degree. And in Fahrenheit, 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Yes, this is the temperature of normal body. Please try to remember it. It is a fact. Actually, it is not given in your book. This is not given in your book, but for your general knowledge, I have shown to you. Okay. So remember, the water freeze at 0 degree Celsius means 32 degree Fahrenheit. Water boil at 100 degree Celsius means 212 degree Fahrenheit. Normal body temperature 37 degree means 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, guys, the chapter is over. Now we will begin the new chapter next day, next class, force and energy. Till then, keep patience and keep safe. Yes, be healthy, wash your hand, and don't forget to wear the mask. Okay, we will meet in next class. Till then, bye bye.